And welcome to Prayer and Devotion on this Tuesday. Today is Tuesday, May 14th. It's my mom's birthday. So I am so glad to be with all of you this morning. Starting off, that was Natalie Grant. You are my all in all off of her Worship with Natalie Grant and Friends album. So if you enjoyed that, you can look that up. I enjoyed that. Today we're going to be looking at 2 Corinthians 12, specifically verse 9, and talking about vulnerability. But I'm so glad you're with us this morning. I say good morning. Good morning, Barbara and Valerie. Good to have both of you here today. Praying for you as we begin the day. And Augusta, Priscilla, I'm glad you're both here, keeping each of you in prayer this morning. Good morning, Lanetta and Donna, I'm glad you're both here, praying for you today. And Daniel and Janet, welcome, keeping you in prayer this morning. Good morning, Genevieve. There we go. Genevieve and Michelle, I'm glad you're both here. Praying for each of you this morning. And Celia and Sue, it's good to have both of you here. Praying for you this morning as well. Good morning, Augusta and Blanca. I'm glad you're both here, praying for you this day. And Susan and Labake. Thank you, Labake. praying for both of you today, keeping you both in prayer. And good morning, Vinette and Rosetta. I'm glad you're both here as well. Praying for each of you as we begin the day together. So we're looking at 2 Corinthians chapter 12. I think maybe I'll start in verse 8. So 2 Corinthians 12, 8. It says, you're turning in your Bibles. My name is Cindy Stauffer. I'm blessed to serve as the pastor at the United Methodist Church at New Brunswick. Soon I will be transitioning to a new church in Pennsylvania beginning on July 1. So as we pray for one another, I ask that you pray for the New Brunswick Church, pray for the Westchester Church, pray for me as well. So, but I'm glad you're here now. So let's take a look at 2 Corinthians 12, beginning in verse 8. Three times I appealed to the Lord about this, that it would leave me. But he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you, for power is made perfect in weakness. So I will boast all the more gladly of my weaknesses, so that the power of Christ may dwell in me. Therefore, I am content with weaknesses, insults, hardships, persecutions, and calamities for the sake of Christ. For whenever I am weak, then I am strong. Good morning, Debbie and Al. I'm glad you're both here praying for you this morning. So our devotion, I told you yesterday we're going to stay in the Henry Nouwen, but I'm trying to pick things that I think speak to parts of my own ministry that I think are important. So vulnerability, I know you've heard me preach on it and talk about it. I do believe there's something very core to understanding who we are and understanding vulnerability. Good morning, Christiana. I'm glad you're with us, praying for you this morning. So today's devotion is entitled Vulnerable Like a Bird. Vulnerable like a bird. He writes, life is precious. Not because it is unchangeable like a diamond, but because it is vulnerable like a little bird. To love life means to love its vulnerability. Asking for care, attention, guidance, and support. Life and death are connected by vulnerability. The newborn child and the dying elder both remind us of the preciousness of our lives. Let's not forget the preciousness and the vulnerability of life during the times that we are powerful, successful, and popular. When we talk about the power of the cross of Jesus, for me, it has always been that God would do two things. They're not just the cross, but there are two things that God did for us that represent that we find power in vulnerability. The first is that God came down in the incarnation as a child, that God would become flesh and blood like you and me. That's the first thing. And the second thing is that Jesus on the cross became vulnerable to the worst of the world so that we might see the fullness of God's glory. And that's really hard because the world around us tells us, don't be vulnerable. Cover yourself over. Suit up in armor. And there's a level that I understand why we do that. But the problem is when we live our lives with armor all around us, we also aren't able to connect more fully with one another. There is a way of living and loving that Jesus shows us that's vulnerable and that's scary. But it's also the path to community, to connection, to understanding one another. I sat with a colleague yesterday and we talked about just how do we bridge the divide in our world. When we look at, sometimes we look at one another and like, how can you think that way? Or how can you live or understand things that way? It just doesn't make any sense. And partially it doesn't make any sense because we stay separate from one another. We stay armored up, ready for battle with one another. And seldom do we actually become vulnerable and say, you know, I don't understand, or tell me what it is that you're walking through, or show me more, help me to see. Which is a statement of vulnerability. To say that I don't understand is to be incredibly vulnerable. Most of us want others to think we do understand, that we do know, that we do have the strength and the knowledge and the power and the wisdom and all of those good things, when the truth is that most of the time we don't understand. And there's something very, very vulnerable about acknowledging that. So what I love about today's devotion is that Henry Nouwen says, yeah, there are times that we're incredibly vulnerable. There's also times where we are experiencing power and success and popularity. And it's in those moments that we need to come back and be reminded of the power of Christ in us, in our vulnerability. So today, in today's scripture, Paul is saying, he's talking about the thorn in his flesh that helped, the scripture tells us, it helps him to understand that in his weakness, that is the grace of God is sufficient. And in his weakness, he comes to understand more. In my grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. So in many ways, when we are weak, it is then that we experience the true strength, the true power, the true wisdom. All of those things come not from ourselves, but from the God who loves us. So today, where are the places you feel vulnerable? Maybe you're heading into a meeting and you don't think you've got all the knowledge you need. You may need to lean on a colleague, or maybe you're feeling vulnerable because you're not sure where the money's gonna come to pay the rent this week, or I don't know, we all have something different that we're lifting up. Maybe you're feeling anxious about some tests that are coming up. You're afraid to tell somebody because then it's real, and that's scary too. What are the places in your life where you are feeling most vulnerable? And I'm gonna invite you to do the most vulnerable thing and lift it up on this, but I understand that that's not always a possibility. But if you want to lift it up for us to pray for you today, I invite you to do that. I ask that you pray for me in the midst of this transition, that God will give me the things I need to do in the leaving, and give me the grace to ask the questions in as I move into something new. I don't always know. Often I do not know, but I trust that God will give me all that I need. So what are the things that we're praying for today? Let's pray. God, you are our all in all. When we are weak, it is you that makes us strong. Not anything we have done, not any great power that we possess or knowledge. Our strength comes from you. Forgive us, Lord, when we have been so busy trying to do it on our own that we haven't let you in and we haven't let one another in. Forgive us when we are so fearful that we will be found out, that we layer ourselves in armor and we stand alone and apart from one another. We begin to see each other as enemies instead of as friends. But you have shown us a far better way. You came to us as an infant. You left us through the vulnerability of the cross. And you showed us how to love through it all. Forgive us, Lord, and turn us back to you. When we are vulnerable, give us the grace to dwell in those places. And when the people around us, our parents, our children, are experiencing that same vulnerability, give us the grace to sit with them, to remind them that they're not alone, that they are loved, to care for them the way that you care for us. We thank you for the gift of life, Lord, because it is precious. And too often we forget this. Each moment, each day is a gift from you. Let us live in ways that honors and celebrates this gift. We thank you for this day, for the breath in our lungs, for the sun that has risen, for you who bring great possibility for this day ahead. We thank you for the gift of life. And we lift all of this up to you, Lord Jesus, as together we pray the prayer you taught your disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. So let's see. Oh, okay. Praying for those that are vulnerable. I'm a super ager, praying for that vulnerability. Praying for staff for the first week of camp. Praying for the grace of discernment that I can be better at sharing my faith. Lord, thou knowest me, help me, Lord. Living alone as I age makes me feel vulnerable. For the courage to forgive and ask for forgiveness. Thank you, praying for me. I'm also praying for guidance and gifts to take good care of my mom. And yes, wonderful. Praying for all of you. Thank you for being vulnerable. Thank you for being you. And thank you for being here today. It's good to gather. God loves you, my friends. God loves you. And so do I. Have a very blessed day, and I will see you back here tomorrow.